is the patron saint of the civil rights movement.
But one day, this nation will rise up.
An icon, a martyr who died for justice and peace.
And live out the true meaning of its creed.
But for one Indianapolis man, Dr. Martin Luther King was also just a family friend.
He was one heck of a listener. He was, serious listener. King would just sit there, and he would just sit. And once he spoke, it was like he'd lock in.
Reverend Thomas Brown met Martin Luther King when he was only a teenager.
Now this is Dad with Ralph and King.
Brown's father was Andrew J. Brown, the man considered the most significant civil rights activist in Indianapolis history. King and the elder Brown were lifelong friends. When Dr. King would visit Indianapolis, he would stay in the Browns' home.
It was a place you can rest. The people were very cordial within the black experience. So it was a social refuge and place to relax.
As the saying goes, every thousand-mile journey begins with the first step.
But when they got off the stage of the outside world, when they got behind in the house, they joke, have a good time. Boy, and they all had good appetites, good grief.
Even as a teenager, Reverend Brown saw something in Martin Luther King that the whole world would soon notice, an aura, something that separated him from other leaders.
So what you're describing is sort of a presence.
Charismatic, whatever words we come up with in the 21st century. Yeah, he had a presence.
The civil rights movement also inspired Tom Brown into activism. He was a recruiter for a prominent civil rights group and risked his life organizing in dangerous cities like Selma, Alabama.
You in a dark area and then you see some bright lights behind you, you're gonna say, oh, I got to get out of here. Well, let's call that scared but courageous. See, if you're scared and you freeze, you're dead.
The greatness of America is the right to protest far right.
Like many of King's colleagues, Reverend Thomas Brown says Martin Luther King was fatalistic about his mortality and knew that someday he would probably be sacrificed for his movement.
For the movement, we all knew we all had to be prepared to die for the movement to continue.
We have more of our interview with Reverend Tom Brown on Fox59.com. Log on and you'll hear why civil rights leaders didn't take many pictures of themselves for fear it could cost them their lives. And as we enter into Black History Month, we will continue honoring the legacy of black leaders and sharing their hidden history. You can watch our upcoming stories on our Facebook, YouTube, and Instagram pages, or head on over to fox59.com/hiddenhistory. Interfaith